Education has been described as a British love letter to classic American teen rom-coms. From Breakfast Club to Mean Girls, its creators' love for the genre is peppered throughout the two seasons. Here's a rundown of those references, some of which you might have missed. Oh, and if you haven't finished both seasons, remember, there are spoilers ahead.
I'm sick of this behaviour, man!
Hey, mate. You look fierce.
OK, so you probably didn't miss this, but it's hard to ignore the general John Hughes vibes of Sex Education's visuals. Hughes made some of the most iconic teen films of the 1980s, and Moordale definitely looks more like the kind of school you'd see in 16 Candles or Ferris Bueller's Day Off than a school in England. No school uniforms, full-length lockers, and look, a Letterman jacket.
Heard boys notoriously peak too early. I'd watch out if I were you.
Oh, yeah.
In interviews, the creators of Sex Education have said you should definitely see the series as a British homage to Hughes. Sticking with John Hughes, those references are even part of the storyline. In season two, an unlikely gang is cooped up together in detention, forced to write an essay.
Please, Miss Sands, this is pointless.
OK, you want a challenge. You can spend the rest of detention preparing a presentation on what binds you together as women.
You are joking, right?
No, I'm not. You have 2 hours to enlighten me, unless you want a month of detentions instead.
Which John Hughes film does that remind you of? Yep, that's right, The Breakfast Club.
We are going to write an essay. And when I say essay, I mean essay.
And John Hughes films aren't the only ones given a nod in the series. In fact, there are plenty of moments in Sex Ed that give us big teen movie vibes, though they usually get flipped on their head before long. In both series, you've got your teen house party going a bit out of control, a staple in teen movies.
No, no roses! Oh, my parents are gonna kill me. I barely got over the last party.
Otis's party, for example, has big American Pie energy.
That's number 5 and 6 for the Stiffmeister.
Now, some of Sex Education's most embarrassing sex moments are very American Pie, unsurprisingly, as that's also a film about teens and sex.
Sure? It's not what it looks like.
3 Viagra's bad. Her reaction made it seem like it was bad.
Not to mention, Jean's sexy mum vibes have the aura of Stifler's mum.
Are you lost?
Well, if Stifler's mum was a sex therapist.
Mum's cool. Why aren't you cool?
In season two, Jackson's storyline revolves around him being the popular jock joining the cast of a school play.
Be not her maid, for she is envious.
I think you've heard that delivery, yeah?
High School Musical, anyone? There's also a school dance where all the drama goes down.
Sometimes the people we like don't like us back.
You can see this sort of thing in, well, pick any teen movie from the 80s to the noughties, from Footloose to She's All That.
We can be anything we want to be.
It's so 80s, even Stranger Things got in on the action. Season 2 has the classic school funfair.
Yeah. Can you win me a giant pig?
Including a budding romance on top of a Ferris wheel.
It's a poem by Pablo Neruda.
Oh. I don't know her.
You can see a scene like this in Never Been Kissed.
Is the seat taken?
But in Sex Ed, it's about two guys falling for each other, which is pretty typical of how the show's writers flip what we know from teen rom-coms and make it fresh. There are a couple of movies with multiple callbacks. For example, we think Kat from 90s classic 10 Things I Hate About You and Maeve from Sex Ed would get along like a house on fire.
Hot tubs aren't really my thing.
What is your thing, then?
Complex female characters.
I guess in this society, being male and an asshole makes you worthy of our time.
Jackson's big romantic musical number for Maeve has echoes of the one Heath Ledger's character pulls off on the school bleachers.
Let me love you.
There's also a heartfelt chat on the swings at a house party.
I hate parties.
Yeah, me too.
I hate him.
And a plot line where money is paid in exchange for romantic advice.
He paid you to tell him what I like.
In fact, Maeve and Jackson's relationship gives us callbacks to classic movies too. Jock falls for the smart and or badass girl, as seen in A Cinderella Story.
Sorry, I waited for the rain.
And more recently, The Duff.
Wow, you look beautiful.
Thanks.
It's moments like these that give Sex Ed that gorgeous, timeless quality. And we couldn't do this video without talking about Mean Girls.
Mom, can you pick me up? I'm scared.
Season 2 pays homage to that Tina Fey classic in several ways. Mean Girls has the mathletes.
The limit does not exist.
Sex Education has the quiz heads. Lily introduces Ola to the different groups of Moordale in a similar fashion to Janice's breakdown of the cliques at North Shore High School.
The greatest people you will ever meet, and the worst. Beware of the plastic.
The bong rats can't remember their own names and still think farts are the height of comedy.
Not to mention, Ruby and her gang give us big plastics energy.
The Untouchables rule over us with an iron fist of terror.
Nice dungarees.
Thanks.
Don't make eye contact.
Well, he likes my dungarees.
He doesn't like anyone's dungarees.
But the biggest reference probably comes towards the end of season 2, when Headmaster Gruff gets a hold of Jean's notebook, which is a lot like when Regina George photocopies the burn book.
I can't believe you told Dr. Milburn I had crab.
I said you might have one crab.
Holy shit, Miss Sands loves doing dirty talk with Mr. Hendricks.
That's amazing.
What did Jean do?
Did you write this?
No, I swear.
Then you told somebody.
As with most of these references, Sex Ed takes what is usually a trope and turns it on its head. It's a thing we've seen before. Teen character loses it and does something really disruptive that makes everybody mad. But this is no ordinary show. So with Sex Ed, you see it totally flipped on its head as the adult character, usually seen as the problem solver, creates the mayhem. Never say Sex Education doesn't subvert expectations. So, that's a rundown of the teen movie references in Sex Education. Did you catch them all? And are there any we missed? Let us know in the comments.